Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And I shall see God, whom I shall see for myself, and mine eyes shall behold, and not another. We brought nothing into this world, and it is certain we can carry nothing out. The Lord gave, and the Lord hath taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Bless the name of Jesus. We're gathered here this afternoon in loving memory of Brother Bobsy Mclean, born November 11, 1941, and passed June
everlasting Redeemer and friend. Lord, we thank you for this another day. Lord, a day which you have made, Father. Help us to rejoice and be glad in it. Father, this time as we gather in our dear Brother Bobsy's Thanksgiving service, I pray, God, that you will lead and you will direct us. Because, Lord, without you we are nothing, and without you we can do nothing. Lord, you have given life, and you have seen it fit to call him home at this time. So, Lord, we give you thanks and we give you praise, because you said in everything, Lord, that we should give you thanks. Father, this morning I know the loved ones, they are grieving, they are suffering, but I pray, God, at this time that you will comfort them. Father, that you will help them to realize that you're an everlasting Father, and that you will love us with an everlasting love, a love that passes all understanding. So as we gather today, Lord, to put our brother to rest, I pray, God, that you will intervene at this time, and that you will take supreme control, that you will lead and you will direct us, Lord. And Father, each and every one as we are gathered here, I pray, God, that doors are out of the fold of God and Christ. Father, that they will see the need to surrender their lives before you, before it's too late, and too late shall be their cry. Today, Lord, for the Bobsy of hope, mighty God, because he has chosen you, Lord, a long time ago. So this day he has hope. So today, Lord, I pray, God, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, that as the message goes forth, as the sermon goes forth, Lord, and those that are out of God and Christ, that they will see the need to bow down and to repent before you. Because time clock is striking the hour, and you will soon ascend. We know not the minute nor the hour when you shall call us home. So Lord, I pray, God, that you will help us, Lord, to get ready before it's too late, and too late shall be our cry. This morning, be with us. Strengthen us, Father, as we go through. Because our strength alone will fail. Our strength alone cannot see us through. So I pray, God, that as we go and we grieve, I pray, Lord, that you will strengthen us. Give us courage, mighty God. Help us to endure. And all that we are going through, all that we are passing through, the suffering, the heartache, the pain, I know, Lord, that you will see us through, that you will come to comfort us, Lord, because you are our comfort. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You are our comforter. You are. We continue to give you thanks. We continue to give you praise. Because you are the author and the finisher of our faith. So continue, Lord, to lead us. Continue to direct us, Father, in the path, in the direction that you want us to take while we give thanks. In no other name but the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Andre Taylor, grandson, I invite you to come with the first lesson taken from St. John 16, verse 23 to 28.
Good afternoon, everybody. In that day, you will no longer ask me anything. Very truly, I tell you, my Father will give you whatever you ask in my name. Until now, you have asked for anything in my name. Ask and you will receive, and your joy will be complete. Verse 5. Though I have been speaking figuratively, a time is coming when I will no longer use this kind of language, but will you plainly about my Father. Verse 26, in that day you will ask in my name. I am not saying that I will ask the Father on your behalf. 27, no, the Father himself loves you because you have loved me and have believed that I came from God. Verse 8 and last, I came from my Father and entered the world. Now I am leaving the world and going back to my Father.
God bless you, Andre. I'm going to invite you to stand with me once more as we sing the hymn, When the Roll is Called Up Yonder. When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound and time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal, bright and fair, when the saints of earth shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, when the
and the roll is called up yonder, and
in this song and clapping his hands and singing. When the roll is called up yonder, I will be there. Bless the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Can you just lift your hands and just worship God?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Doreen Ferron's stepdaughter, I invite you to come at this time with your selection.
Follow. Then here in the ring of the seconds. Thank you.
for a country to which I
in the spirit. can almost see the Father as he said, son, go and get my children, cause I don't mean I to cry. And we will be going home.
Thank you.
blessed name of Jesus. Papa, Bobsy, Brother Bobsy, my grandfather was a kind, jovial, and a loving person. There was never a dull moment when you're with him. He always gave you something to laugh about. His children remember him as a disciplinarian. So his daughters recall instances when they would stop at the pond at standpipe, and when they got home, Papa would have Mass Bob, which is his whip, waiting for them. He doesn't believe in sparing the rod and spoiling the child. Grandpa would say to us, his children and grandchildren, once you have life and God, that's the most important thing. The two most important places to Papa were his field and church. Papa was a hard worker who would rise early in the morning and drink a cup of tea and go to his field. So you could always depend on getting goodies from his field. And it didn't matter who you were. When Barbara comes from Kingston, Papa would pack her up with food to go home. He would do the same for Alton, or when we call him Alti, when he visits from America and returning home. Grandpa's so cheap, it seems, I wonder if he knew money. Sometimes when persons from his church and the community purchase from him, when asked for the price, his favorite sayings were, "It's all right, man," or "Give me up." He would sometimes offer money based on persons' conscience, and he took what he got. My grandfather was a God-fearing person who likes to help others no matter what. He could be seen at several grave digging graves. He gave to his church from his field, especially at the time of harvest. You could see him coming up the road with his yams, plantains, bananas, and jellies. Sister Marisol,
Miss Baby Girl,
was his good friend. If you passed by his house in the evening, and did not see him on the red chair on the veranda, or if he's not inside the house, he's by Miss Baby Girl having a good chat. Although a hard worker, my grandfather lived a very simple life. It seems like being rich in this life or having much was never a goal for Papa. Having a humbly godly life seemed to have been his goal. He was always early for church and was always involved. He was very dependable and reliable, and his family and his church knew that. My grandfather loved the Lord. May the life he lived speak for him. May the service he gave speak for him. May his soul rest in peace.
Daughter, you have painted quite a vivid picture of Brother Mclean. Amen. And we can testify to all those that at harvest time, Brother Mclean was always ready. Amen. And if you get to church early, Brother Mclean is always here early, waiting to greet you. And he will step outside and reach for you outside and give you a good handshake. That was Brother Mclean. And we give God thanks for him.
Amen.
And the young people he loved dearly. He would participate in any event that they had. He would even attend youth meetings. Brother Mclean was so supportive. And that is why this afternoon the young people will be performing a dance in memory of Brother Mclean. I invite the dance ministry group to come at this time. While they're coming, one of Brother Mclean's favorite songs when he gets up to do his testimony was, do you know that song?
For he alone is worthy to worship and adore the Lamb of God, victorious, the risen Lord. He purchased my redemption, my righteousness is He. Exalt the name
is parents Agatha Swaby, Moon, and John McLean. Bobsy was the oldest of 13 children. So it was expected of him to lead and be a role model for his younger siblings. While growing up, Uncle Bobsy was such a lover of goats. Those animals always gave him such delight. And as long as there was daylight, he was always going to the shop, thus earning him the name, the shop rooster. Carry go bring come, save a bread, not to take over. Just to name a few, are songs done by Justin Hines, a Jamaican singer that Uncle Bobsy loved to drop legs to, him and his father. Although he was a loving brother to his siblings, they couldn't dare touch his things. No way, he was that skeptic, or else there was hell to pay. In the years to follow, Uncle Bobsy would leave Hanover and went to St. Catherine, where he met and fell in love with his first wife, Lynette Wellington, who in turn gave him 7 children and 1 adoptive daughter. It was here that he settled to work and raise his family. After the passing of his first wife, he continued to concentrate on his family, nurturing, caring, and raising them the best way that he knew how. Throughout that time, he decided that he needed another female companion, one who could assist him with the children. And it is here where he met Marva Wright, Auntie Marva, his second wife, and gained 3 stepchildren. In all that time, he continued to work with the Wallens farm, for he was never embarrassed about hard work, giving of himself to them many years. Coming here for summer holidays was such fun. Uncle always had a cutlass for me because he knew I loved going to the bush. In the district of Cheesefield, Uncle Bobsy was loved by both old and young, for he touched them in one way or another, and he in turn loved them as well. He especially loved his church, the City Mission Church. Here he worshiped for many years. For any time that he was going to church, Gosi could be seen with his Bible under his arm and God at the forefront of his mind. We have many fond memories of Uncle Bobsy. One such memory is of him loving whenever rain fell. He would say something like, rain a fall, make it fall, make it fall. Food of the plant data, make it fall. Can God bush a man in? Another memory is of him going to Blunt Street City Mission Church and him calling his sister saying, Melva, cook food, carry comfy way. For as much as me no know town, me be find a yard for the food. Oh, there are so many fond memories that we could go on and on about. Memories now and then, but time doesn't allow for all of them, or we would be here all day. God looked around his garden, and he found an empty place. He then looked down upon this earth and saw your tired face. He put his arms around you and lifted you to rest. God's garden must be beautiful. He always takes the best. He knew that you were suffering. He knew you were in pain. He knew that you would never get well on earth again. He saw that the road was getting rough and the hills are hard to climb. So he closed your weary eyelids and whispered peace be thine. It broke our hearts to lose you, but you didn't go alone, for part of us went with you the day God called you home. Sleep in peace, Uncle Bobsy.
I'm on my way.
once with me now, after which the next voice you will hear will be that of the speaker for today. It's no other person than the pastor of this church, Reverend Fraser. He will be sharing the word of God. I want to know more about my Jesus.
Knowing that Brother Bobsy new God. Amen? Amen. And that indeed the Lord has called him home and he's resting. Amen?
Amen.
Indeed he is at rest. Oh, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Oh, praise God.
Praise the Lord.
Oh, praise God. Recently we had the funeral service of Sister Sharika. And well, today is Brother McLean's time. Sister Sharika, in her own right, served this church in a great way. Very dedicated. Brother Bobsy, Brother McLean, in his unique way, in his special way, also served this church greatly. The first time I took note of Brother Bobsy, it was when I was in my early 20s. I came here for a program, and in those days we would have the Cheesefield would have services over the church there. And I took note of Brother Bobsy from those days. He loved to testify.
Amen.
Yes? Doesn't matter what is happening, or you know, he's going to come up there, he's going to stand up and he's going to testify, he's going to share, he's going to talk about what the Lord has done for him.
Amen.
And you know, he would tell you plain and straight how rough and tough he was, and when would, you know, do certain things, and but when the Lord took a hold of his life, amen, he surrendered his life to God. I salute his memory today. Amen. Personally, Brother Bobsy was faithful. A very faithful brother. I would just have to say, Brother Bobsy, you're going to have a baptism. Brother Bobsy would say, Pastor, everything is good. He would see to the pool being prepared for the new candidates to be baptized.
Amen.
For that cause, Brother Bobsy was dedicated to that cause. Amen?
Amen.
I honor his memory. Brother Bobsy, when the earth others spoke of how he would come very early. But let me highlight a certain point about him that pastors really love about their memory. As a pastor bringing the gospel, back in the day, Sister White, you love to hear, come on, bear me up in the spirit.
Amen.
And you know, ministers would say, come on, man, bear me up.
Amen.
Brother Bobsy is sitting at the back there. I could hear him bearing me up.
Amen.
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 What about him? He was so attentive to the word.
Yes.
His eyes are fixed on you and he's there. Some persons would be, you know, sleeping off and dozing off. Brother Bobsy is perked up, attentive, looking around.
Yes.
And as part of make a mistake, Brother Bobsy is backing me up and, you know, correcting and so on.
Yes.
Brother Bobsy, he usually says, you know, he's not a man of much, you know, reading and whatever. But I tell you, here, I would give him an A. Yes? For being attentive. For being a faithful brother to this church. Brother Bobsy, I really missed him. Yes, indeed, I do. And I honor his memory today. And believe me, I believe he made it in. Amen?
Amen.
I believe he made it in. Amen. Revelation 14 and verse 13. And I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, write, blessed are the dead which die in the Lord. From henceforth, yea, saith the Spirit, that they may rest from from their labors and their works. Do follow them. Oh, praise God. Oh, praise the Lord. John was on the Isle of Patmos. Being there as a prisoner, he was connected to God in such a way that he heard a voice from heaven saying unto him, come on, document this, write it down, write. This is important. You know, when you write something, you put it in writing, it is important. God wanted this to be known. It is very, very, very important. Amen. Therefore, God said to John, write, blessed are the dead which die in the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. From henceforth, said the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors. And their works do follow them. Amen. Hallelujah. So, I can make reference of Brother Bobsy. He wasn't a rich man in the sense of have a lot of earthly possession, money and so on. But indeed, yes, he gave his heart to the Lord. Amen. 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 And because of that, he lived a life that when the time came that he took ill, he was able to when he came home from the hospital, he was able to call the close family together and had a good talk with you and strengthen you and talk about how you must love each other. He prepared himself. Amen? And he also prepared you. He was like making up his jewels, knowing that he's heading home. And that's a good sign. Amen. Today, he's not here, his body's here. But take note, he's blessed. Amen? At this point, he is blessed. It's one thing in this life to have riches and, you know, quote, being blessed. People terms having a lot of money, big house, big car, that, boy, you're blessed. Amen? He might not have those things when he was alive. However, according to what God told John on the Isle of Patmos, at this time, Brother Bobsy is blessed. Amen. Amen. Because it is written in the scriptures, amen, blessed are the dead which die in the Lord. Amen. Amen. You see, a lot of us will die. We will die. However, how we die is important.
Amen.
Amen. How we die is important. In the sense that if we die in the Lord, die in a state of righteousness, die with the consciousness that I am redeemed, die with the consciousness knowing that my life is about to be taken. I'm in the departure lounge of my sick bed and I can make it right with God. Such a person indeed is able to make it in. Amen. And John, receiving this wonderful message, this wonderful, glorious message, blessed are the dead which die in the in the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. You see, some of us, when we do go, it's difficult to say that this person is blessed. Mm. Hmm? Mm. They might be blessed, yes, in this life with riches, but after death, it is important, yes, that at that state, when we are dead, that we can come up to this point that where the scripture says, blessed are who? The dead who die in the Lord. It is important for us to die how? In the Lord. To be at peace, to be at rest. Amen. Take note, in St. Luke 16, it speaks of the rich man and the poor man, Lazarus. And this rich man had almost everything to his comfort. However, this poor man, Lazarus, sat at his gate. Yeah. And he had a, you know, sore dog would come and make a sore. And he would eat. Yes, from the crumbs from eaten left and so on. He was a poor man. Mm. But it so happened that the rich man died. Yes? And also, this poor man, Lazarus, died also. But after a while, we take note of the contrast between this rich man who lived here on earth and this poor man, Lazarus. The rich man looked up, and what he saw? He saw that Lazarus was in the bosom of Abraham. In other words, he was at rest. He was at peace.
Amen.
He was in comfort.
Amen.
Amen. And he, the rich man, was in torment.
Amen.
The table was turned. It takes a life that is ready. Amen. A life that is surrendered to God. Yes. To reach in the hearts, in the bosom of Abraham. Amen.
Amen.
And that life was the life that that poor man lived. Amen. That rich man lived a life away from serving God. Amen.
Amen.
So, you see, where the tree falls, there it shall lie till judgment takes its course. And brothers and sisters, the blessings of this time cannot be compared to the blessings of heaven.
Amen.
Amen. And I'm here to strengthen, yes, brothers and sisters in Christ, to know that you don't worry too much about how poor you are here.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Don't be too concerned about how you can't make ends meet.
Mm.
Live for Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Serve him in spirit and in truth.
Amen.
If it's like eating the crumbs from the rich table, and you just can't afford anything better, go on, serve your God. But one thing, have this hope, sister wife, that one day, amen. so-called blessed here. Amen. God say you are blessed if you die in Him.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Oh, bless the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
That they rest from their labors and their works do follow them. Rest from sin. Amen. Rest from temptation. Rest from sorrow. Rest from sicknesses. Rest from persecution. Amen. There is a rest. A sweet rest. So, brothers and sisters in Christ, hold on. Yes, don't give up. Because like this poor man Lazarus, take note. Like this poor man Lazarus, amen. If we die in the Lord, we will indeed be in the arms of sweet deliverance, indeed blessed of the Lord. Amen. This songwriter saw it this way. I have heard of a land, yeah, on a far away strand. It's a beautiful home of the soul built by Jesus on high. There we never shall die. It's a land where we'll never grow old. Strong, Brother Mclean. A hard worker, indeed. Yes, he would work hard in his field. Yes, but the time came when suddenly he took ill. Yes, you see, when we get up to that age, yes, 70 and over, yes, we indeed get old. But this songwriter looking, amen, at the place, say, never grow old in a land where we'll never grow old. Oh, hallelujah. When our work here is done and life's crown is won and our troubles and trials are o'er, all our sorrow will end and our voices will blend with the loved one who have gone on before. Yes. Hallelujah. Never, hallelujah, never grow old in a land. Sister White, Sister Pearlie, oh yes, oh Deaconess Morrison, yes, we will never grow old. So I'm strengthening you today. You won't grow old in that land.
Amen.
And the Lord Jesus has gone to do what? Prepare a place for us. Amen. Never, never, never grow old in this life. Only we have hope in Christ. We would be men most miserable. Amen? But thank God for this blessed hope. Hallelujah. Thank God for this hope. Yes? In a land where we'll never grow old. You are here today. Perhaps you looking at today's service and somehow something is just sticking at your heart. You're not sure where you will be if the Lord should, you know, call you home. If death, yes, should come and, you know, just snatch you. your way. You're not sure where you will be if you would die in the Lord. You're not saved. You haven't repented of your sin. You are still living a life that is pleasing to God. I'm here to say to you today, you can make it right with Him today. Something through this funeral service is tugging at your heart. Amen. To say, why not surrender your life to Him? Today, indeed, you can do that. You can be numbered among the blessed. Yes. That dies in the Lord. Amen. You'll be able to rest from your labor. Amen. So, I'm beseeching you. The tug you feel, yes, on your heart, yes, speaking to you, yes, you could be the very next, yes, it's a good tug to your heart, yes, saying, where are you with God? Yes, where are you with God? If you should die now, if you should die tomorrow, will you die in the Lord? Or will you die out of the Lord in your sins? You can make that corrective situation and turn over your life to the Lord and serve Him in spirit and in truth. Amen. Amen. We're in a time when persons are just dying suddenly. Yes? Just dying, just like that, and we don't know who will be the next. The young, the old, middle age, just dying. Will it be you next? To be certain that you die in the Lord, it is for you to repent of your sins. Amen? To repent of your sins. Pray and ask the Lord. Say, Lord, forgive me of my sins. Yes, you're feeling the tug to your heart. He's speaking to you today. Yes, you could be the next. Yes. And the Lord is imploring you at this time. Make it in. Surrender that life to Him. For behold, I come quickly. Amen. And my reward is with me to pay every man according as their work shall be. Amen. He that is filthy, amen, will be filthy still. And he that is righteous will be righteous still. Amen. You have received the word. Amen. I don't have to go any further, but ask you, yes, to bow your heads at this time. Amen. And really seriously reflect on your life. Yes, reflect on your situation. Where am I with God? Certainly there is a God. Where am I? If I should die, will I die in the Lord? It's prayer time. And right where you are in your seat, you can make it right. Yes, you can make it right. Open up to God and pray. Yes, yes, let us pray.
And while I pray, you pray right where you are. Talk to Jesus. Surrender your life to him. You who you're a backslider, return to him. Amen. In this time, Almighty God, we thank you for today. We thank you, Lord, that you're able, Lord, to save to the utmost at this time. And I pray, God, that as we reach out to you, I pray, Lord, that you will save to the utmost. Oh, God, I pray, God, that you risen. Reveal yourself right now. Yes, and speak clearly, Lord, to someone right now. Oh, who isn't right with you. And Lord, draw them closer to you. In the name of Jesus, I pray that someone will surrender their life to you now. Oh, who hear your word and make a conscious decision to say, Lord, henceforth, I will serve you in spirit and in truth. So right now, God, I pray that you will touch, Lord, that you will deliver, and that you will save in the name of Jesus. Amen. Right where you are, right where you are. Yes, I indeed believe that the Lord, yes, has really tugged at your heart. Yes, and I believe if even one of you have prayed and said, yes, Lord, I surrender my life to you. Today, I want to implore you, follow on with this surrender that you have made now, with the prayer you have made. Find a place of worship. Yes, where you can be taught the good news of salvation. Where you can be strengthened, yes, with the word of the Lord Jesus Christ to live the life for him. Amen. That if tomorrow or a couple of weeks is your day, indeed, you will die in the Lord. You will be counted as one of the blessed. Oh, praise God. Oh, praise the Lord. Oh, praise the Lord. Oh, praise God. So take note. Yes, be serious with the prayer you made today. Yes. Yes. Find a church. Yes. Yes. Read it in the Word of God. Get baptized and walk with the Lord, because certainly he's coming back. Amen. And he's coming soon for individuals. Yes. And indeed, the second coming will soon be here. God bless you in Jesus' name.
He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit says to the church. Amen. Deacon McLaren is coming at this time to pray for the family. Could you please stand, family members?
Eternal Father, Lord God, let me give you thanks this day, Lord, for your Son, Jesus Christ. Father, in your word, you said, Almighty God, that when one born, we should laugh. When one die, we should cry, we should laugh. But God, because of human nature, Lord, we cannot live. Sometimes God becomes so fearful, becomes so hard to us. So at this moment, God, come and what we are going through, this family, Lord, I pray, God, that we give you strength. It's very hard sometimes, God, to know the blues and the wrong. But God, they lose their father, their grandfather, their sister, their brother, a friend of the family, even the church member, lost someone. We pray, God, that each and every one of us, God, you may stand beside us. It is hard to laugh, but God, even what we, God, understand. Give us the strength, give us the knowledge, give us the understanding, Lord, to be strong in this time. I pray for the family. God, I may walk out here, Lord, even in tears, their hearts may be numb, but God, whisper something. Whisper something in their heart, God, that they may be strengthened at the time. Not only God, they want to strengthen them, but God, touch them, that they may follow their grandfather, their father, God, and turn to you, Almighty God, because their father and grandfather, and whatever to them, Lord, have lived a life before them. Lord, let them change their mind, see what their father has done, and bless them. God, I leave the family in your hand, and we tell you thanks in Jesus' name.
Amen. God bless you. We will now be doing the recessional hymn, Come Ye That Love the Lord. And at the singing of the last verse, the ministers will go first, followed by the casket, and then the family members and the audience. Could you stand with me?